Welcome back to the Stratus Arena at the Rotman Center on the campus of Fairleigh Dickinson University in Hackensack, New Jersey, for our fourth game tonight. Number 8 seeded Hackensack versus number 1 seeded Bergen Catholic. This will be the fourth game in the 61st Oscar F. Thompson Memorial Bergen County Jamboree. Hello, buddy. I'm Loud and Fury along with John Francola. John, Bergen Catholic seeded number 1. They're big, they're strong, they're versatile, they're athletic, they're quick.
And they have the Italian connection.
And they seeded number 1 in the Jamboree.
They can play. They've lost a game against Don Bosco, and they beat Don Bosco. And as far as the Comets, this is the best the Comets have played in many years. In their losses, the only loss, there was one loss that they shouldn't have lost against Northern Highland. The rest of the time they lost against St. Mary Elizabeth, Gil Bernard, Roselle Catholic. This is a reputable team. They'll play full court press. They're going to run up and down. They could. If Bergen doesn't play their A game, this team can beat them.
Well, it's a great team. They have a great outstanding ball player. You're going to get a kick of watching them, Atiba Taylor Jr. For Bergen Catholic, there's a trio of players that John would call them, the Italian connection. We enjoyed it. This is going to be an outstanding game. It's going to be a fast-moving game. And the winner here becomes the final of the number team to get into the Final Four next week.
Bergen also has the young Mazzona, the freshman who starts on this team. Plus, they have Benning, who was a Division I player last year. This is going to be a track meet.
So we're going to have they're starting to do the introductions. You've seen some of them. We apologize for coming on late. We only had about 15 minutes to turn everything around. We're going to turn this over to the voice of the Jamboree, the great Joe Hausman.
Zero. For Hackensack High School, number 11, Tavon Sutherland, number 11. For the Crusaders of Bergen Catholic High School, number 11, Miles Wilmot, number 11. For Hackensack High School, number 5, Philip Reinhardt, number 5. For the Crusaders, number 4, injured Michael Butch, number 4. For the Comets of Hackensack High School, number 15, Torin Porte, number 15. For Bergen Catholic High School, number 2, Jason Earl, number 2. For the Comets of Hackensack High School, number 34, Brent Freemeyer, number 34. Bergen Catholic High School, number 1, Tim Algenio, number 1. For Hackensack High School, number 21, Razaya Sorrell, number 21. For the Crusaders of Bergen Catholic High School, number 12, Vinny Tickerico, number 12. Bergen Catholic High School, number 5, Justin Riches, number 5. For the Crusaders of Bergen Catholic High School, number 32, Seth Freemantle. And for the Crusaders of Bergen Catholic High School, number 15, Rhoda Asiati, number 15. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineups for both teams, beginning with a visitor, the Comets of Hackensack High School in alternating teams. Starting on forward this afternoon, a 6 foot, 7-inch junior, number 35, Chandler Williams, number 35. At the guard position for the Crusaders, a 6'2" sophomore, number 25, Doug Eddard, number 25.
By Joe Hausman. This is the fourth game. Not bad, John. We started at about 12. It's 5:30.
We're still kicking. I haven't gotten off this seat or go across the way. Well, we got to get all the starters and check in. Thank goodness for that one sandwich I had early and a bottle of water.
That helped. That was a good sandwich. We want to thank
it was
Gourmet Dining and George Kuzma for sending the food here. Donating it. These are the others, all of them, corporations that supported the 2017 Jamboree, TD Bank, The Record, Sports Time, Lifesavers, the aforementioned Gourmet Dining, George Kuzma, and of course, Washington Community Television.
We give you the heart and soul.
We sure do.
The money.
Drakeford has. Hands over to Swinson. Swinson. Into
Saliba.
Saliba, that BJ, no good. Ball's bouncing around. They're going to say it's off Hackensack, and Bergen will throw it in. As they're having some
powwow.
That's Leon Steinberg, and next to him is Ed Kraumer. Hey, where did Jim McConville go? Must have went into a
1-2-2 zone, which it could double team on both sides, Larry.
Stefanini was. Surrounded by three.
Watch the double team on both sides. If they stay out.
Benelli wanted a shot. Benning. That was a lob pass.
Yep.
That's Coach Taylor. Jump shot in and out. Zona puts it up and in.
The freshman.
Matt Zona with the rebound. Taylor. Left-hand shot, foul. Billy Taylor played here.
Billy Armstrong.
Billy Armstrong, and we did his games. So Billy
We had him.
He played and won a championship here. And played, I think, twice for champions. 21, I think, when he lost. Back in the early 90s. Taylor missed the first one. That's his wife, who's the scorekeeper.
Yeah.
So Taylor misses two of them. Benelli has as he brings it up. They're like a 6'8 guard, huh? Benning now takes over.
Oh.
A little slip. Edith back out to Benning, looking to work inside.
Stefanini. Yeah, a little zone.
Outside
they like the double team.
No good. That was Benelli. Drakeford all the way down, lays it up, no good. Stefanini with the rebound. Going to bring it across quickly to Benning. Benning, reverse, no good. Stefanini makes it good. 4-0, Bergen Catholic leads. Hackensack. Saliba back outside to Drakeford.
I may have to bring out the stopwatch.
Yep, they're going to call
another team that both teams are on.
Foul on Edit. This is Desmond. We caught him last game. He hasn't stopped. He hasn't stopped yet.
I know. I was going to give him my watch. I would have 10,000. Without blinking an eyelash.
Swanson pulls it out.
Or an eye, or a leg.
Once inside, Saliba, the whistle.
Looks like 23.
Yeah, it is 23, Benelli.
Benelli.
Shot's good. Oh, Jimmy McConville's back. He's allowed to get up. Makes two. So it's a 4-2 game. Bergen Catholic leads the beginning of things here. This is our fourth game. Three teams have qualified for the final four. St. Joe's will play Don Bosco Prep, and Teaneck will play the winner of this game as Stefanini lays it in. Swanson into the front court. Swanson hands it off and fouled as Williams gets the handoff from Swanson, gets it in and is fouled.
You got Chandler Williams on the basket, right? Basket count.
So 6'7", Williams will go. Edit will sit down.
He's a junior.
And Isaiah Givens, Tim Allegio is in.
6'5", David Burton Catholic.
Algenio is in, number one. Around, and they're gonna call Stefanini with a walk.
He's trying to get the reason.
And Johnny got a number one there, Algenio, another Italian.
Yeah, but he's not from Italy.
You don't know. You're gonna go. That's your job to investigate.
The parents are probably Italian.
Taylor, watched by Stefanini. Drakeford hits over Benning. 7-6.
That was a 2-point goal.
Stefanini on the side, hits for three. 9-7, Bergen leads.
He's got 7 points already, Stefanini, representing Italy.
That was a nice pass from Stefanini to Swanson into Drakeford, I believe.
Chandler Williams with the basket.
Okay. Inside, and a turnaround jumper by Zona.
What was that on?
Zona, 11-9, Bergen leads. Drakeford goes in, no good. Taken down by Zona. Stefanini has. Out to Benning. And save. Saved by Algenio. Inside again. Algenio wants from the outside. Long shot, no good, batting around. Drakeford fights for it and rolls out of bounds.
I don't know if you heard, Larry. They were camped inside for a long time. But no call is legal. So 11-9, we got to get a breath, a little breath.
Stefanini, a long three-pointer.
I'll tell you what, he's
14-9, Bergen.
He's got 10 points already.
He's Stefanini. Warming up, man.
Warming up. We have to make another box for him. Keep going this.
Taylor's going to be short. Taken down by Benelli. Hands out Ginio. Back out to Stefanini. Comes out with it. Benning backs up. Benning outside.
The other
Benelli
Italian.
Rims the basket. Drakeford with the rebound. Off to Saliba. Saliba drives the line. He's fouled.
Two shots. 10.
Fouls on Stefanini.
His second personal. And you got number one shooting two shots.
Saliba hits the
Stefanini,
first one.
Stefanini, he's got three fouls?
Yeah.
We just got the worst. Stefanini's got three fouls.
Wow, that fast? Zach Fremantle is in.
So he has 10 points. He's going to sit for a while.
So Fremantle is in. Alginio puts it up. No good. Taken down by Williams. Over to Taylor. Taylor hounded by Alginio. Taylor drives all the way in. Puts it up. No good. Back up. No good. Taken down by Benelli. Here's where Don Bosco is very strong under those baskets. Benelli from the outside. It's the rim. No good. Taken down by Swanson. Bounces it to Taylor. Puts it up. No good. Put up again. And in.
Tip by three.
Yeah,
tip his own shot.
14-13, Bergen leads. Benelli. Algenio hands to Benning. No good. Bouncing around and taken. By number 21, who snuck in here.
Sorrell. Yep.
Jeff Long. Saliba, no good. Long has it. Fires it back out to Swanson. And we start again. Swanson, fighting around pick. Stolen by Logenio. All the way down. Has the lane. They're going to call a foul on Swanson.
Basket's good.
The basket counts. So Swanson picks up the foul. Jason Earl is in for Bergen. And he hits.
Well, 17-13.
Jump shot, no good. Taken down by Earl. Goes all the way. They're going to call player control foul.
On number two,
Mr. Earl.
Sutherland. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Mr. Earl.
Joran Porti will come in for Hackensack, number 15.
I was 21?
I believe so.
B.J. Saliba.
A long jump shot by Benning for three. 20-15 with 50 seconds to go.
See, that's what I expected for a first quarter. Potentially.
Saliba puts it up. No good. Taken down by Earl. Quickly up court. Benning. Zona. Blocked by Williams.
35 on the foul.
They're going to say a foul.
That is that personal foul. Charge to number 35, Taylor Williams.
What a future this young man has. Number 24, a freshman. 6'8".
Which means he's going to get bigger, right?
He could get stronger. That he will. Look at the, look how big the feet are. The toes. Look at that. They got to be 18, 19. Those are boats. Nice foul shooter.
Jeff Law. Rebound. 34 seconds to go in the quarter. Taylor driving. Knocked away.
Off number three, off his leg.
Yeah, Earl knocked it off his leg.
When I heard the whistle, I figured they're going to call a foul.
He hit the ball right off his knee. Algenio slowly brings it up with 19 seconds to go. Hands it to Benny.
Yeah, this is a relaxed 1-2-2.
Bergen Cackle will shoot for the last shot.
You know, they always like to press on both sides.
And they're going to call Taylor for a foul with 4 seconds. I don't know. That's a tough foul to take. Zona will throw it in. Benning. No good. And the quarter comes to an end. 21-15, Bergen Catholic over Hackensack. You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer group from the Township of Washington.
Little Italian song. Well, you got 23, Vanelli. And number 10, Stefanini's got a couple of fouls. And my watch is telling me to take a walk. Maybe they don't want me to be an announcer anymore.
It's been a long day.
I'm getting punchy.
And now you got Ricky fooling around. Ricky's our director. You people don't know. It gives me a chance to say, over to my right, to my left, is Greg Maturo of the record. He's been covering the 4 games tonight. You could read his articles in the evening, get a jump on it by going to NordJersey.com and read Greg Matura's articles before it comes out in the morning. So
that's the back of them.
Yeah, go to NordJersey.com, click on Greg Matura and see the article, read his article, get all the information, find out why things happened, how things happened, before you have to go out into the cold and pick it up in this slush and snow. Again, go to NordJersey.com and read Greg Matura the night before. I usually get it around 9 o'clock at night. So I'm way ahead of the crowd in the morning. Yeah, I get it early. What do you want me to tell you?
Look at this young man.
Ricky's laughing. Up.
So we start the second quarter, 21-15.
Algenio throws it into Zona, gets blocked away. Drakeford quickly up to Taylor. Taylor, no good. Taken down. Oh, we have someone sneak in here. Algenio puts it up and gets it in. Miles Wilmont is in for Bergen Catholic. Drakeford, no good. Put back up by Long and foul.
Fifteen on a foul?
I believe so.
Rona Esayare.
So
on a foul.
Jeff Long will go to the line. No, I'm sorry. Raise it, Sorrell. I got the wrong one here. I'm sorry.
You're right. No, it was the number 15, right?
Yeah, but the 21's going to shoot.
Yeah, Esayari had the foul.
Right.
And Sorrell is shooting. Missed two?
Yes, he did. So Sorrell missed two. Long jumper is good by Benning.
So he's got two threes.
Well, the ball gets thrown away as it dribbles out of bounds.
Pretty much equal as far as rebounds, turnovers, as Billy Armstrong calls the play. 26-15.
Eugenio over to Benning. Quick. Long jump shot. No good by Wilmot. Up comes Drakeford. Drakeford drives in, puts it up, no good. Taken down by Fremantle. Over to Benelli. Benning for three. Count it. One, two, three.
That's three threes for Benning.
Timeout is being called by Hackensack with 6:34 to go. It's 29-15. Bergen Catholic leads Hackensack. The Bergen County Coach Association and the Jamboree Committee would like to thank the following corporations for their wonderful support of this year's Jamboree. TD Bank, The Record, Sports Time, Lifesavers, Inc., Gourmet Dining, and Washington Community Television. That's us, WCTV. All of you didn't know it.
So Benning is doing a great job. He's got three threes. You know, I was talking to one of the spectators about Benning. Last year he was the Division I player. He must have been injured. But he's getting all his shots under control. Big shooter.
Yeah, this is all Bergen Catholic so far. We had a nice crowd here today, John, all day. Considering the weather was bad, it was snow, rain, sleet, hail.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, it was a great crowd. Everybody was into the game. Dwight Englewood had a fantastic game against Teaneck.
Sure did. We had a nice talk after the game.
With Coach Rudolph.
I mean, he's got to call him.
I asked him if I could coach his team.
We told him.
He just smiled.
Your team's on the way up. It's a very young team. Just, it needs experience.
He could use a Christmas gift to kids 6'7".
I think that team needs is time to play together and have time. Swanson. Swanson goes all the way up, lays it up, and it's fouled. So Michael Swanson misses the first one.
You know, they seem a little bit out of sync.
They sure do. They sure
after
do.
After we saw them play in the pre-quarters at Tenafly, they were aggressive.
Oh, yeah.
And everybody was moving.
Benny, almost thrown to me. Inside the Benelli. Eugenio will back it up. A little whistle on the play.
3 second violation.
All right. 3 second violation. You don't see that call too much, do you?
No. Usually everybody knows that you can't stay more.
They're cutting through the thing.
I can't believe that young man left.
No,
I want my watch back. My watch back.
And a foul.
Let's see who it is.
Three.
A T-Batel.
That was on Benny?
It was number three, Benny, yes. And a T-Batel has got two shots.
This is the FDU people who work here. They've all... Yeah, they're in the luxury suite upstairs.
They're probably having some food.
I hope so.
That's his first foul shot he made. He missed three in a row.
Taylor makes one. Eugenio. Back outside. And we have a whistle.
Foul. Looks like 21.
Vinny,
and it's near by Taylor.
Swanson.
Oh.
And we got a whistle.
Play a control foul.
Oh, yeah. Swanson has the foul. He picked the foul up.
Swanson. His second foul.
Vinny Tricovico is in.
He just, out goes he just four. So Mikael Swanson.
Yeah, Swanson with the foul. Tricovico is in number 12.
Yes.
Okay.
Now they're doing a little modified full court. Trying to double team on both sides.
Yeah, you got to break it up a little bit. Algenio over to Stefanini. Stefanini wanted, pulled it back. Long jump shot, no good.
Oh.
By Chicharito. Taylor into the forecourt. Driving all the way and lays it in. That's what we saw last week.
Yeah, Atiba Taylor, that's what they need. Him be aggressive, go to the hoop. Look at that. I love when they dive.
You can see here now, whistle on the play. They're going to call a foul or timeout or what?
Could be.
Nope. One, five.
15.
Push. Torin Porte. Porte. There's the coach. Aaron Taylor.
Going back in time, he was a point guard when we did Hackensack. And his assistant coach played with him.
Knocked away from behind by Taylor. They're going to call him for a foul. Billy Armstrong.
Second personal.
Has guided his team to the number one seed here.
Part of the Italian connection. But this is.
And he hits.
This is Matt Zona. The freshman. We're going to make him part of the Italian connection.
Onto.
So Matt Zona, 7 points.
Oh, it's ball stolen, coming back. Benelli, Algenio, wants to shoot, and hits. You know, Algenio just looked around and said, okay, I'll shoot it. It was a casual shot. Nice lay in there. Look by Saliba.
Number one.
Saliba put it in there. Zona, hook shot. Wow, you don't see that too much. Use that big size of his. Sorrell, no good. Comes down. He has the rebound, puts it up, no good. Rebound by Saliba, gets it in.
They're starting to get a little emotion in the game.
Zona wants for three, and he hits from the outside. 39-23, Bergen leads. Taylor over Zona for two.
That's the point. We need a calculator going.
Algenio lays it up, no good. Sorrell has it.
Here we go, another
hands
sprint.
It to Taylor. He's going the other way, watched by Stefanini. Outside. Drakeford. Sorrell. No good. Taken down by Benelli. Benelli hands knocked it away almost. Algenio. Giacano shoots. No good. Taken down by Benelli. Benelli hits as a turnaround jumper. It's now 41-25 with 2:39 to go. Shot. No
takes
good.
About 5 seconds to go up and back and shoot.
Yep.
Here we go
that
again.
That was Porte. And finally, that play will stop. A Sorrell fouled Stefanini.
That's what I expected from the beginning. You know, up and back, full speed. 4, 5, 6 seconds. Timeout.
Timeout on the court with 2:27 to go. 41-25, we're in the second quarter. The Bergen County Coach Association, the Jamboree Committee, would like to thank the staff and the athletic department of Fairleigh Dickinson University for holding quarterfinals, semifinals, and championship game. We'd like to mention that the Jamboree Committee, mentioned all of them, they do so much work and so much effort goes into this tournament. Paul Pugliese and Ed Kramer are the co-chairmen. Leon Steinberg, John Ryan, Rookie Corcoran, and Chris Anibal. The BCAA liaison is Tom Curry and Chris Gaston.
Well, Sorrell has 7 rebounds for Hackensack.
He's part of the crowd.
So we got two shots coming to Gabe Stefanini. Two shots.
So Stefanini's
got three rebounds.
Stefanini's going to line for two, huh?
Yep. Shooting foul. He's got 10 points in the first quarter. Then he had to sit out because of foul trouble.
It's a big one.
We were never told what part of Italy they come from.
I don't know.
I know.
We should ask him. We get a chance, we gotta ask him.
We should call Pier Francesco Oliva and find out. So an 18-point lead. Pier Francesco Oliva, remember we interviewed him in Italian.
Yeah, I remember that interview.
Oh, it's good.
Oh, it was funny.
I may have to get, depending on the score of this game, I may have to go into Italian. So if we send this to Italy, they'll understand the game.
Yeah, sure. Saliba.
Pallacanestra.
Watched by Chicharico. Saliba.
Oh.
They are going to call a foul.
Play control foul.
On Saliba. Benning. You like this from Zona. Tries a 3-point again. Saliba with the rebound. Saliba stops and shoots in and out. Taken down by Wilmot.
BJ's got 10 points. Saliba.
2 more points for Zona.
Say he's having one heck of a quarter.
He's having one heck of a year.
2, 4, 7, 9 points in this quarter. 5 in the first quarter. He's got 14.
Saliba with the shot. No good. Taken down by Wilmot. Off to Benning.
Where's 24?
Benning.
There he is. Oh!
Knocked away. And a whistle on the play. Out of bounds. 107 to go. Bergen leads by 20 points.
They have 45 points, Larry. They got a shot for 100 points.
Whoa. Grant Freemeyer, number 34, checked in. 6'7 junior.
A third foul. I'm going to have to check. It's kind of tough for us to hear the voice.
Zona will sit down.
Could that have been Zona?
Matt will sit down for this quarter. Shot is good.
That was Taylor we just saw, the head coach.
Porting.
You know, point guards make good coaches. Billy Armstrong was a point guard. There's Taylor, the coach.
Taylor's going to sit down. So Porte will hit another one, or try to hit another one, and
got the roll.
Yes, he got the basket.
shooter roll. 18-point differential.
Shot outside, no good by Wilmont. That was Earl. And Wilmont with the rebound and
another foul.
Foul under there, yeah. With 54.1 seconds.
Fremantle will get on the line for two.
Zach Freeman.
6'8".
Fremantle missed the first one. And he's a sophomore too. They are young.
They definitely are young. And very good. They're going to be losing the Italian connection, but.
Misses both of them.
0 for 2. Eyes are blue.
Freemeyer with the rebound. Whoop. Saliba. Back outside for a long one. It's good.
Porte.
So Porte with the 3-pointer. Back outside to Benning. We're 27 seconds. See the clock in the lower right. Benning.
In with the trees.
Gets the rim. Saliba hits.
See, that's what I expected. I expected up and down shoot three-pointers.
4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Good if it goes.
It's good.
It's
four
good.
Threes for Benning.
So Benning hits a three and gets it to 50 points for Bergen Catholic, 32 for Hackensack. You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer group from the township of Washington. We are back here at halftime, almost finished halftime, 50-32. Bergen Catholic leads. They've done everything correct offensively, defensively, hit the open man, make the shots, and John has the stats to prove it.
Well, for the Comets, it was 17-5 before today. Drakeford had 2 points, no foul. Saliba had 12 points, one foul. Taylor had 7 points, two fouls. Swanson had 2 fouls, 1 point. Porte had 5 points, one foul. And Chandler Williams, 5 points and one foul. A total of 32 for Bergen Catholic. Algerio had 8 points, 1-3. Taj Benning, 4 threes and a deuce for 14 points. Gabe Stefanini, 2 fouls, 12 points. Thomas Benelli, 2 points, one foul. Matt Zona, the freshman, 14 points, 1-3, no fouls. And so for a total of 50, they're in this process. They could hit 100 points tonight.
Well, they got 50 in the first. It tends to slow down the second half.
It was 21 in the first quarter and 29 in the second quarter.
They're on the way up. Who knows? Well, they played a very good first half, John. They really have.
Oh, the best in a while I've seen him play.
18-point lead.
You know, good passing, hitting the open man, and they've been hitting the threes.
Oh, yeah. Taylor, Saliba. Oops, lost my glasses there for a second. Taylor for a big three and hits it. Steve Taylor Jr. hits for three.
And that's what they're going to have to do. They have to shoot the three and play that full court press. You know, double teaming on the side.
Got to hold. Like everything else in sport, you're going to have to win the game off defense.
Absolutely.
Going to have
and they have the defense that could win,
right.
But Bergen is not giving them the opportunity to double team in the corners. Billy Armstrong right here is doing a great job with this team. He's my neighbor, by the way.
Benelli with a turnaround.
That, oh. That's too easy.
My God, what a nice jump around, eh?
Unbelievable.
So Benelli picks up two more. Taylor comes right back with two. Thank you.
see the way the double team.
Finelli.
When you do a 1-2-2, you can do a double team on each side.
And Zona, give him two more, John.
He's got 16.
54-37, Bergen leads. Taylor, give him two more.
I better get a calculator.
Benning, down the middle. Puts it up, in and fouled.
This is the old-fashioned way. Make the basket and get fouled.
Vazia Cyril will come in. Number 21. And Janiel Williams will sit down.
See, that's a good way of doing it. You know, if you're tired as a referee, just take the ball. Let me have the ball a little bit. Let me check it. And this way you relax a little bit, you know, instead of being involved in a racetrack.
All right, Benny gets his roll. Makes it 57. 39. Saliba drives, no good. Cyril has it, back outside, no good. Cyril again, blocked by Zona.
Oh, see that? The Italian connection protected me. That was number 10.
Stefanini.
Gabe Stefanini protected us. Grazie, signore.
Stefanini has.
He didn't respond to me.
Give him, yeah, no, he didn't talk. Two more points for Stefanini. 59-39.
I just said thank you. Thank you, my man.
20-point lead now for Bergen Catholic. Sorrell, Swanston, no good. Zona with the big rebound over to Benning. Hit it for three, hits for three. Make it 62-39, and Bergen Catholic is just running away with this. They're playing at a high, high level. Foul.
We'll
shoot
too.
They're going to call a foul on Zona. As Saliba will go to the line.
He'll get two shots. But I believe when you foul, you shoot five. Make sure he doesn't shoot the ball.
Right. Gotcha. And there's another one. So Saliba hits two. Benning picks it up quickly. And to Benelli, Zona, back to Stefanini. No good, taken down by Porte.
They didn't give credit for two foul shots there, I don't know.
Saliba, put back in by Sorrell. Hit it for three.
Unless
no good. Saliba with the rebound. Over to Taylor. Taylor from way downtown. In and out.
In and out.
And off. We're going to say it was off Porte. 4:51 to go. 62-43.
That one went all the way in and out. Oh, they.
Quickly to Stefanini.
No.
Holds up and hits. That's an easy two-pointer for him. 64-43, Bergen Catholic leads. Porte comes around. Cyril. Jumper, no good. Taken down by Erdit. In the forecourt. Knocked out of bounds by Williams.
Well, again, substitution right now.
Isaiah Day is in. Stefanini pulls out.
That was probably the easiest shot he had all night.
Yeah.
About a five-footer.
That's the ones you have a tough time
with. That's the ones you miss.
Swanston, he didn't miss.
Two.
So Swanston hits. Headed. Benning. 3:50 to go in the third. Stefanini thought about it. Ball gets thrown away.
Oh.
Forte lays it in. Torin Porter. Give him two.
Nice move underneath to the hoop.
Stefanini doubled and triple teamed. Gets away. Hands it to Benning. We'll have an easy layup. So give Benning two more points.
19 points for Benning.
Look at this. No good. Fremantle with the rebound. Stefanini gets away. Hit to Benning. And Benning lays it up. 68. 47. Knocked away. I said they knock it away.
I see 100.
Algenio was in.
Out goes Benning, 16, 18, 21 points.
Oh, they're going to have a lot of points here today, John. He got 68 points with 2:57 to go in the third.
So he got almost 11 minutes.
And the way they were scoring. So
this young
hits.
Man is, shoots nicely, Saliba.
Algenio. Over to Earl. And we have a whistle as Stefanini was surrounded. And a timeout on the court, called by Billy Armstrong. So we have 2:25 to go, 68-48. Bergen Catholic leads Hackettstown.
Oh, no. Ooh. Who is this guy? Who is this guy? Giovanni Ugo.
I have no idea.
Raimondo Romano Francola.
It's like Bobby Mays.
But I know Fiume. That's River. But that's now Rijeka in Yugoslav, and now it's Croatia. And that's where I was born. I don't have a birth certificate, by the way.
Here we go.
I was born in a house.
Under a sink.
Yeah, so I just have a piece of paper that says I was born on October 28, 1942. What can
that's
I tell
it?
You? Don't you, leave the country.
You don't have a birth certificate?
I do not have a birth certificate.
How did you get a passport?
I had other things to in its place. And I gave him a couple of bucks. Oh, there she is.
I think that's Bill Armstrong's little girl.
And that's his mother-in-law.
All right. John Mehta.
Absolutely.
By the house.
They live a couple of houses away.
Looking for your passport?
No.
I still wonder how you got a passport.
I did. As a matter of fact, I'll tell you about Social Security.
We don't want to say too much.
I'll tell you.
You don't want to say too much.
I've been here legal. Matter of fact, they changed my name when I came to this country. You see all that Italian rigmarole?
Yeah.
They gave my name was John Francola.
That was it.
That's it. Oh, they had a U for Ugo. All right.
So you were John U?
John U. But what they did at my job, they made that a U to a V, so I never made the varsity. I was JV. And a basket by, it looks three.
Yeah, that's by Taylor.
I'll tell you, what a life.
What a life. Nice running by number two.
Earl.
Lays it up, and a foul by inside, might be Fremantle. With 1:47 to go.
You know, they're starting to make a run at it, 70-51.
that's a say there? About 15?
They're down 19.
Yeah. So Saliba will go to the line. As people here on the table can't believe John Francola's story about his name and birth certificate.
They felt it would be easier to be John.
I understand.
And here I was, my first day of school, I have to tell you. Once we get this next time out.
You didn't know who you were.
I knew my name was now John. Not Giovanni.
Quickly up court, Saliba makes a nice move, gets the ball back. Outside, Taylor, no good.
Yeah, they got to use the three to
Algenio.
Get back in the game.
And stuffed.
By 32.
Zach Fremantle. Terrell gets fouled. Looks like Fremantle fouled him. We got 72-52 with 1:13 to go.
They're starting to make a little noise, Hackensack. And that's where you have to go. Well, you know, when you go to get Social Security, you got to go to Hackensack.
Yeah.
So I went there, and of course, they wanted to see a passport.
Okay, now we're going along.
So I gave him my passport.
You had a passport, right?
I was able to get a passport. And I had a passport, but the passport was brand new. So I said, the woman says, where's your old passport? This is my first passport. Well, you got to get the backing. I don't have the backing. Well, we'll have to send it to Philadelphia to see whether or not you get Social Security. I said, I worked for a company for 41 years. What are you kidding me?
Call your congressman. Earl goes up, puts it up, and banks it. Jason Earl for 2 points. Foul. Stefanini with the foul.
One more story, and then we stop, Larry.
Go ahead, one more story.
My first day in school. It was October, right? It came 1951. I go in with shorts on.
You want short pants?
I had short pants. In Italy, you wear short pants. And everybody, they introduced me. I'm a little kid there.
All right.
And Taylor, they were all laughing at me.
I don't know why.
Because I had shorts.
Oh, okay.
So I went home. And you know, it took me almost 14 years to wear shorts again.
I thought you were telling me they didn't take the shorts off and you wore them.
Oh, no,
years.
They didn't do that. That was it. So that's my story. 19 points down for Hackensack.
Ball as we away switch by gears. Drakeford, right, Pete DeFalco. 44.9 seconds to go, 74-55.
26 away from the century mark. But this is another team that should do damage, Hackensack, in the state tournament.
Boom up. And he's fouled.
He'll get two.
Miles Woolmuth. So Woolmuth will go to the line for two.
So we had a great day today, Larry.
You had a what?
A great day here.
Oh, I mean, recapping your life.
might have to write a book.
Oh, yeah.
Short story.
A short story, my life in shorts.
But really, that's a true story about the shorts.
No, I believe it. Well,
that was it. Took years for me to put shorts on. Now I love shorts.
What brings you back to when you were a youngster? Oh, nice play inside. That was a nice rebound. Swanston. 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Benning. Went in uncontested. 1 second to go. Swanson's got to put it up. He can't. Three quarters are in the book. 78-57. Bergen Catholic leads. Hackensack, you are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer access group.
I lost a couple of baskets.
The township of Washington. Games next week. February 19th will be the semifinals starting at 5 o'clock. Championship will be Friday, February 24th at 7 p.m. Final quarter of the day. Taylor.
Oh, what a save.
You know, nice save in there.
By Swanston.
Saliba hits. Bulmot will throw it in. Put this back on. Algenio pitches out to Stefanini, and Stefanini adds to the lead. 81-59. Cyril, no good. Zona with another rebound. Algenio has it. He'll bring it up slowly. Pitches it out. Stefanini wants three more. Rims the basket. No good. Wilmot steals it. Literally. Benning.
He was looking for three. He's had four.
Give and go. Wilmot. Benning. Back outside. And a whistle. What are you going to call? Justin Regis, number five, is in for Bergen Catholic.
And will Argenio's day be over? Yes.
Swanston, back out to Taylor. Taylor drives on the
hand
reverse.
Oh, what a move.
Gets it in. Regis brings it up now with Wilmot. Stefanini. Knocked away by Saliba. And they're gonna call a foul on Regis.
It should be number five.
Aaron Taylor is the coach for Hackensack.
So it looks like 24 may be done for the day?
Could be.
I'm gonna put him done.
6:22 to go. They're going to start sitting their players down. Zona's sitting
with
down.
With 16 points.
Stefanini won't be long. Give and go and give.
Benning's got 23.
Saliba puts it up. No good. Rebound by Bergen. Over to Stefanini.
Oh, nice pass.
Nice pass inside.
Eseyade. With a basket.
Nice pass by Taylor. Two more points for Taylor.
I tell you, Taylor's a scoring machine.
And how many points do you have, John?
He's got 22 right now.
22 points. You know, it's amazing. Hackensack has 63 points. If they played any other game today, they would have won. No one scored more than 63.
I agree with you.
And they trailed by 18 points to Bergen, who has a remarkable 85 points with 5:35 to go.
First half, 50 points by Bergen. It was 50-32.
Well, we'd like to say thank you to everyone here. We're back next year. 16. Kathy and the staff.
Yeah.
Jack on security.
I'm missing,
they were wonderful
day.
Who we got here 11. We got here 9:30 this morning as we sloshed our way through the snow, and we got here. Just want to thank everybody at Fairleigh Dickinson University for helping with the quarterfinals today, and then next week at the semis and finals. We want to thank. I want to thank the Gourmet Dining, George Kuzma, for providing food for everyone here at the table and for the committee and for their guests. Welcome after a long day. We had something to eat upstairs. The Bergen County Coach Association, I thank the Jamboree Committee, TD Bank, The Record, Sports Time, Lifesaver, the aforementioned Gourmet Dining, and Washington Community Television. The only question is, how many points will Bergen Catholic score here? Wilmot. Rebound. Stefanini. It looked like Taylor was just hugging him. And we'd like to thank everybody from WCTV who came to help. Garrett Seckley, who was here for two games. Ida, who did the directing, and now she's up there shooting. Emily, who came through the snow. Stefanini for another three. Ricky Wojcicki.
Stefanini has
now.
22.
Nick Besink, who's been sitting at courtside for the last 5 hours. Want to thank him. Oh. Stefanini misses. There's Nick on the table. We want to thank Pete DeVries, the voice of Bergen Catholic. He does the press box announcing during football games. Bobby Maines for all the statistics he's given us. There's Bobby down there. There's Emily. We can try to get everybody. Emily. Thanks, Emily. A lot of work. And somebody over there. We don't know who's there.
Is anybody sleeping up there?
Oh, there's Ida.
Oh, look at that.
Ida's with a new boyfriend.
What's happening up there?
Hey, not helping over here. No wonder why we're not getting any shots. Stefanini comes out as they call timeout. Bergen now has 90 points. There she is. She's exhausted. Put up by Taylor, I believe.
Yes, it is. He's got 24.
Wilmot.
Double team.
Cyril up to Taylor. Back in, Saliba puts it in and he's fouled. To the Bergen County Jamboree Committee, Paul Pugliese and Ed Kraumer, Leon Steinberg, John Ryan, Ricky Corcoran, Chris Annabel, the Bergen County Coach Association liaison to this committee, Tom Curry, Chris Gaskin. The Bergen County Coach Association, Roger Pelletieri, Brian McDonald, Robert Grady, Howie Conklin. Executive Secretaries Ed Shear and Joe Delpuno Sr.
You got to bring this a little closer.
Yeah. There we go. Oh, this is Brian. He's shooting for Bergen Catholic, and Ida's taking a nap.
He's using the back. That's a perfect place to take a nap when somebody's working.
Bergen Catholic has emptied its bench with 4 minutes to go. Brian Rice is in number 20. Back out to the aforementioned Brian Rice, no good. Taylor lays it up and in. Chicorico, answer Rice, back to Chicorico. Over to Regis. And a foul.
I'm just gonna close out.
So I think I got everybody. I'm sorry if I don't think I missed everyone. To everyone who's been so kind to us since we got here at 9:30 this morning, my clock is reading 10 to 7. We're pushing almost 10 hours. Yeah, Bobby Maines just told me he saw me at 7 o'clock this morning. So we've been running around almost 12 hours.
I think I sat at this chair for 12 hours. Or when I walked across to get some more information. All right. I'm just gonna mention a few of the scores.
3:40 to go.
You know, Larry,
Catholic
gonna,
will move
I'm
on to the
quote.
To the final four. And John, we have four teams left. As Swanson steals, then we have a whistle. And good.
Count it.
You're gonna count it. It's 90-71. Since we started playing way back the end of January, every high seed up to now has won. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4 playing next week.
Well, this one is this is in a game. I mean, they're up by 19. I mean, something could happen. Maybe a forfeit.
So Swanson will go to the line. Completes a three-point play. So next week, fashion. John, we could talk a little bit about next week because we just finished this game out here. It looked as though the four top teams would make it. As a whistle, we just may go to the line or a timeout. It looks like a timeout. 3:30 to go, 90-72. The crowd is petered out too.
I think they're in shock.
People want to go home now. You know, John, we went all the way back to the 25th of January. It looked as though that the chalk would hold and that when we got to the finals, 1, 2, 3, 4 would be here. But every year it looks like that, and there's always an upset. Last year, two Don Bosco Prep played four St. Joseph's for the final, and St. Joseph wins. When you get to 1, 2, 3, 4, there's very little daylight between the teams.
You're right.
So we're going to have a great two games next week.
Series. St. Joe's against Don Bosco and Bergen against
Teaneck.
So you could have 1 and 2 play for the championship. Or unless 3 and 5 decide to, or 3 and 4 decide to
win those games. Something else you're going to have, there's no work the next day because it's a holiday. President's holiday, so you can come out, watch the game, enjoy yourself. And don't worry about getting up tomorrow to go to work. Out here to Drakeford. And Drakeford misses. Rice has. Can we go inside? Mishandled pass by Rice. We're at the 250 mark. No good. Trico Rico with the ball.
You got
knocked
all
away. Saliba coming the other way. And fouled. 2:34 to go.
And Saliba will get a chance to make another shot.
He has a bunch of points, doesn't he?
Right now he's got 23 and going for 24.
Well, Burger Catholic has brought back Edit. Benelli.
You got Benelli back in the game.
Yeah.
Eder also.
Wilmot.
Well, you know, you're looking at a 15-point game right now, Larry. It's only 15 points.
It's true. And they're going to call a jump ball. As Earl was
and
tied up.
That's why you have a couple of substitutions. At 2:22 on the clock.
90-75.
They're checking.
Let's see what the discussion's here all about.
And I can't help them. Well, you can see the 2:22, 90-75. Well, here the coach, Taylor.
Long discussion here.
After a long day.
Make sure they get it right.
And that's what they have to do.
Doesn't matter what the score is or what the situation.
Oh, and 8.
You've got to get it right.
15 points could be attained.
I mean,
it's only 15 points right now. Here we go. They had their meeting. It looks like number
Benelli's
20.
Benelli's going to go to the line. No, I'm sorry. They're going to.
No, they just got 3 across.
Earl's going to put it in. Hackensack is pleading its case. They lost. They had a wide open, say they hits. 92 points for Bergen. The only question is, will they hit 100?
Well, it could be done easy.
Another foul.
Yeah, because Hackensack, you know and I know it, are going to try to score as many points.
Here goes Pat Rice on his way home. Pat Rice serve for a block. NorthJersey.com. No, NorthJerseySports.com. And he writes football, covers football. He's an encyclopedia of football all over the state.
Absolutely. See, this is what I expected early in the game.
Gotta get it across.
You know, Larry?
Just do, and they're gonna say walk. Benelli walk. Good pressure by Hackensack. Let's see if Hackensack can hit a three now. Make it interesting, somewhat interesting, with 1:51 to go. Swanston. Stolen by Eerdit. No good. Take him back.
This may be good.
Wilmot puts it up and in. 94 points, 75. So next week's game, Sean, here will be at 5 p.m. and 7 p.m. I would believe Bergen Catholic and Teaneck will probably play the first, the second game, because they're the number
they're
one
number
seed.
Seed.
And then the first game, not bad.
Bosco Joe's.
Huh? That should be a great one.
It'll be on the big court. Oh, look at this shot.
3 points. And a timeout call by Bergen Catholic, 94 to 78.
16-point difference.
So that those are the games. That's drawing a large, large crowd next week.
Oh, 1 through 4.
Hopefully the weather will be fine.
It
Although today's
be.
Weather
it
didn't
lucky.
Slow the crowd down at all. It was a nice group, nice crowd here.
I guess they cleared the food up there. There's no more yep. food up top. Yeah, this game, 1:19 to go.
Yep.
I give a lot of credit to Hackensack coming back.
You know,
They had an astronomical.
Hey, listen, they played a well-talented Bergen Catholic number one seed. They scored 78 points on them with a minute to go in the game. Edith will try three, no good. Round still running. Gideon has, up we go. 57 seconds to go and a foul. The only question here is, what's the final score going to be? And then how fast we can get out of here?
Well, I'm just going to give you the three high scores for Bergen. As a matter of fact, I could give you those high scores right
now. Yeah, I wanted to do that now. We said goodbye to everybody, I think. We didn't miss anyone, did we?
I don't think so. If we did, we apologize. We went into a little shtick with
your passport,
to the U.S.
Yeah. But I was all right.
Well, you had 23 points for Benning. He had a great game, four threes, 21 points Stefanini, and 16 points for Zona. Zona played, the freshman really did a great job.
Right, as a steal.
He's going to be an outstanding player. I think a Division I prospect.
Steady with another rebound.
So now we're up to 98. So we apologize that we're not going to give you everybody's scores. Tomorrow, you'll be able to go on the record.
Yeah, read.
If not tomorrow, the following day.
Read Matura's article tonight.
Absolutely.
25 seconds to go and a timeout.
I'll just give you a couple of high scores for Hackensack. I think with 18 points, so you have.
Hackensack's going to get out of here playing, scoring 80 points. So why don't you give us some of the high scores now, and then we'll be able to say goodbye.
All right. Taylor has 29 points. Saliba, his sidekick, 24 points. And let me just give you some of the other ones. Forte had 9. So those pretty much, and we'll give you Swanston had 8 points. So those are your high scores. Hackensack will be a powerhouse in Group 3. They've lost all the schools that are a lot better than they are. You know, they played a big schedule.
Right. Right.
And again, Bergen, get ready for the final.
And we'll be here next week at 5 o'clock, carrying the game. You'll be able to see it on our stations on Verizon, Channel 24, WCTV.us on the internet.
We had a great day,
yeah,
to say the least.
It was a wonderful day.
You know, 8 outstanding teams.
Pushing 10 hours, but it was fun.
Yeah, it's enjoyable.
We could have been, what, we could have been digging ditches,
Sunday?
Right, John?
Yeah, that's right. We could have been sitting at home and not doing anything.
Bergen will just hold the ball.
Yeah, I don't think they want, I don't think they want to score.
Give everybody a chance to go home, and that will do it. 98-80. Bergen Cat defeats Hackensack and moves on to the Final Four, where they will face Teaneck next week here at the Stratus Arena. Again, for everybody at WCTV, we hope you enjoyed it. It was a great day here. Thank you, everyone. We'll see you back here next Sunday for the semifinals. Good night, everybody.